everyone, welcome back to another one of Bequita Beauty's YouTube videos. I am Bequita Beauty and today I have a college related video for everyone. So school is just around the corner for a lot of us and I just thought this video would be appropriate just because I have already uploaded a video on how to graduate college early, and so I just thought why not also do a video explaining the pros and the cons to graduating early, just because now that I am officially done with all of my classes, I do realize that there are a lot of things that I've noticed that can be cons or a lot of things that I am happy about now that I did finish my classes early. Notice how I'm not saying that I graduated already because I still have an internship requirement that I have to do. However, the classes are completely out of the way for me. I am officially done with all of my classes. So I just thought this video would be beneficial for a lot of you guys. So I decided to go ahead and sit down and film just casual and talk to you all about it. As always, be sure to like and comment and subscribe if you haven't already and hit that bell notification so you're notified whenever I upload a new video. So let's go ahead and get on started with this video. All right, so I don't know if I should start with the cons first or with the pros. I don't want to start off on a negative note. So I'm just gonna start off with the pros and then end on a lighter note at the end. So one major pro about graduating early is that you get to save money. You save money on rent if you're moving out of state or out of the city and you're not gonna be commuting from your house. You save money on tuition, which has increased for a lot of us and is ridiculous. College in the US is so expensive, and I feel like even if you just shave off one semester, it's so beneficial to you and whoever is paying for your tuition. And I mean, even just everything, all of the other expenses that you have while you are away, I mean, there's groceries, there's clothes, books, there's so much that goes into your college experience financially that a lot of us don't even think about until we're finally there, like buying, you know, supplies, or you watch hauls and you need to buy this and that. You're basically buying everything for a new living space. So another pro is that you get a head start on life, which is amazing, and it's so nice to finally just have school off your shoulders. It just feels really, it feels a little different just because most of our life is spent in a classroom or listening to a teacher or obeying someone else's commands essentially. But I think this is very exciting, and although there is a lot of uncertainty, especially right now, getting a head start after finishing with classes just feels so rewarding because you do feel like you challenge yourself. And I mean, that takes me on to my next point. You challenge yourself if you do go ahead and aim for graduating early. I did explain this in my other video explaining why you should graduate early. However, I do remember the big challenges that I had to face while I was struggling to try to graduate early, and you know, it was always a plan of mine to graduate early, so whenever something came up, I wasn't doing too well in a class, I felt so frustrated with taking so many units. Now that that's all over, I feel not unstoppable, but I do feel so strong after going through all of that, just because I feel like I was very privileged my entire life. So just having that challenge of doing everything on my own and, you know, working multiple jobs, taking a ton of units, taking summer classes, sometimes sacrificing weekends, I think it's all completely worth it in the end, because not only is it good in the moment, but you do feel good later on whenever you do face some hard challenges. I always look back and remember, man, okay, I was working 3 jobs, I was doing like 20 units at the time, I think I can do this. So I wrote this list like kind of a while back, and I did write less time required after high school to finish a college degree, and I'm not too sure what that means, but I guess it means that like after high school the race just gets cut a lot shorter compared to your other friends. I mean, not to mention the fact that after high school everyone's paths are just so different. I know people who like become celebrities, artists, singers, they create their own business, they are real estate agents, they are all over the place, and it's super exciting. Some of them are having kids already, which is insane. And so everyone's paths are so different. However, compared to all of the other students that are going to be going to college, you will probably be finishing a lot faster. Of course, it really depends on your major as well. Like I mentioned in my other video, I know engineering majors are in college for like 10 years, doctors, lawyers have school for so long after. But for me as a business student, I'd say I'm one of the lucky ones and have the luxury of graduating early. So I do feel like I had a head start, and after high school, I felt like I was almost done. Now that I am, it did go by really, really fast. And now I'm gonna go ahead and move on to the cons, but as I said before, I'm gonna try my hardest to end on a positive note just because I really don't want to be pessimistic. And I do think that this is an incredible opportunity if you do have the opportunity to graduate and finish college or your studies early. So my first con would be that reality definitely hits harder and a lot faster, especially because, you know, you're ready to move on after college. And although I was excited to no longer have to sit in a class and listen to a professor and study for exams that I'm not even going to remember after taking them, I do feel really scared at the amount of uncertainty that there is now. I mean, just with this pandemic that we have going on right now, not only was that like a huge hit to so many students, but a lot of them are just going towards their master's degree at this point because there's just no point in entering the workforce when there essentially is none. A lot of people are struggling to keep the jobs that they already have. So reality has just hit a lot harder, and it has been a lot tougher just accepting the fact that you don't really know where your life is going, you know? I feel like planning to graduate early was like my last plan that actually worked, if that makes sense. Now, you know, I had always, after moving to San Diego, I had always planned on coming back to LA, finding a job here, and like starting a family here eventually. But I think now I miss San Diego more than ever, and I don't know if it's because I feel like I'm missing out on college still or what, but I do think that it's been a little tougher, especially because it didn't feel like I was done, you know? I mean, not only were we all on lockdown, but I was taking my classes from abroad, like my Spanish classes, I was taking them here in LA. So I feel like that made it feel less real or less structured just because, you know, their school system is completely different too. So, and it was all online. So it was just like really weird, and I would have never thought that that's how I would have ended my college career, if that makes sense. So it feels a little odd. Another really major con that I never thought about until probably now is that I will be missing out on my last year, or what would have been my last year had I finished college in 4 years. And I'm getting major FOMO. I loved my roommates so much, coming home to them and seeing them every day. And this is actually the first year that most of us aren't going to be living together. And it's just weird coming back home and realizing that I live under my parents' roof again. I'm going to have to follow their whatever they say. Like, leaving that independence after like barely getting a glimpse of it once I live in San Diego, it's really weird. I am blessed. I feel so lucky to have a home to come here to and a family that loves me and my sister. We bonded more than ever, I guess, because she missed me the last 3 years that I was gone. But I feel like I made a name for myself in San Diego. And so now that I'm done and I don't have a legitimate reason to go back, at least right now, I am a little bummed just because I feel like it would have been great. But at the end of the day, I guess the thing that comforts me is that we have this global pandemic anyway, so I wouldn't have been able to really enjoy it as much as I would have wanted to. We made so many memories, and I feel like I was just getting so excited to make more. I mean, I did know that I would be done in 3 years, so I always had that in the back of my mind. But you know, you look back at pictures and it's like, wow, I created so many more memories than I thought. So many that I don't even, you know, remember, or just like our nights, you know, cooking with our friends or just going out to the beach. Cause I mean, the beach is still close here in LA, but you catch so much traffic, it's not the same. And last but not least, a con to graduating early would definitely have to be a level of uncertainty. And I feel like whether you graduated early or not, there always is that level of uncertainty, unless you really have a job offer like right after you leave college or you have like a set plan. There isn't much that you do know. I am so glad that I took amazing classes, had great professors, made amazing memories, but there still is such a big level of uncertainty of like what's gonna happen, you know? So many people plan their entire lives after college, and now after this pandemic again happened, sometimes I even feel like, what's the point of just planning everything if at the end it could all come down just as quick? So that level of uncertainty just really hits, and it really makes me scared to want to plan something. Right now, I do think that, you know, for the majority of my life, classes took up so much of my time, and I'm sure it takes up everyone's time. Getting to school, being in school, studying for exams, doing homework. A lot of it is busy work, while a lot of it is important and essential. I do think that, you know, a lot of my time now can go into activities and hobbies that I really enjoy. I do want to take YouTube, for example, a lot more seriously. I want to travel, I want to work, I want to, you know, I will be able to do a lot of things that I wasn't able to do just because so much of my time was spent in a classroom or doing something that was school related. And that's not to say that I'm ungrateful for my college experience. I hope you can tell that I really enjoyed college and the memories that I made. But I am excited for what the future holds, even if I don't know what it is. And I feel like you should too if you're watching this video and you're already done with college. We're all in this together, and I'm just really excited. It does feel kind of weird moving into adulthood because there's never really like a set date when you look at your calendar and you're like, okay, today I become an adult. You just kind of realize it as time goes on. I feel like it hit in college when I was working and all of my roommates were working really, and so like we never really got to see each other and we never really sat down and planned to have like our last meal together or planned to like have our last outing together. It all kind of just like stopped all together because we all just got so busy at once. Now I'm looking at like my Snapchat memories, my Instagram memories, and I'm seeing how little and young and naive I was 2 years ago, but how much I thought that I knew. And looking now, I just realize that I know nothing. So while I am terrified of what may happen and I'm scared of not really knowing what to do with my life, I am really excited and looking forward to how we all turn out because I do think that we're in the right track, and I feel like we don't give ourselves enough credit for going through all of that we're going through. We think that we have to stay busy all the time, we have to stay stressed, we have to work on something or else we feel useless, or at least I've noticed that that's very American of me to think. After studying abroad, you realize that it's okay to just breathe and have fun and have a good time, but I think it's important to also just do things that you want to do. Life is so short and you never know what may happen. Maybe graduating early will be great for you and you'll want to get out of a classroom ASAP and get out of that college experience ambiance, because obviously it's different for everyone and it may be very beneficial to you getting out of there and then just growing on your own and creating just a person out of yourself. Or graduating early might not be all that for you. Maybe you realize that, hey, maybe I want to add another semester because yeah, I will be saving money, but at what cost really? Like, you would be saying goodbye to your friends, to your memories, because I feel like college is kind of one of the last points in your life where you get to live just so selfish and you get to just think about yourself. Now that it's all gone, for me at least, it's kind of like, okay, now what? I guess with all of that being said, finishing college early either might be for you or it might not be for you. I'm just here to list the facts and list my experiences on what I thought it was and the pros and the cons. So I do hope that this video was really helpful for you all. I kind of went on a tangent later on and just started talking about my fears of graduating early, but hopefully it helped for some of you, and I'm really excited. You know, I may have been scared, but I am overall just really excited, and I hope you are too for whatever journey you're going through. It'll be good, and just remember that everything happens for a reason. So, with all of that being said, I'm gonna go ahead and go now. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe. My social medias will be linked down below. I felt the most comfortable making this video, maybe because everything I was saying came from the heart. It's just so fresh in my memory right now, finishing college and being done with that stage in my life. So I hope the sincerity came through, and that's it. I hope you all have a great week. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye.